Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, we're going over this new launch tool I have. If you watched some of my previous videos, I went over this launch OBD2 scanner. This thing is more than your normal OBD2 scanner. It's actually a diagnostic tool for Toyota and Lexus vehicles, as well as other vehicles if you get the right models for those vehicles. So on today's video, I'm gonna go over all the features for the Toyota Sienna. We'll go through all the different menus, the different diagnostics, and everything that you can do on the Sienna. A lot of these things are actually factory technician options that you can select in the menus here. It's just like Toyota Techstream that the technicians use at the dealer. So if you saw all my previous videos on this tool, this thing is not your ordinary OBD2 reader. It actually has a bunch of software, which is basically like Techstream. In my opinion, it's kind of a handheld copy of Techstream. It comes with all the different diagnostics and options that you can set from the factory that you may not have access to normally from the different menus. So these things are basically dealer level technician diagnostics. You go through the ABS menu, you go through the TPMS, you can program keys, you could do all of that. So if you saw my previous videos, you'll know all about it. If you haven't seen them, go ahead and check out those videos. I go over a little bit more on all the different details and all the different functions of this thing, but on today's video, we'll just focus on the Sienna. So on the Sienna, what you need to do, the OBD2 plug is right here. You'll see it right below here, the white plug. Just plug your tool right into it, and then this thing is self-powered by the car itself, so you don't need to get any batteries or anything for it, and it just comes right back on there. So once you plug it in and start the car up, it'll run everything through, and then you can run all the diagnostics on it. And as you can see, my Sienna has footwell lights. I installed those a long time ago, early on when I got this car. I set that to the actual doors and everything, so it opens and closes and turns on with the lights with the doors. But that's something I did a long time ago. I don't really have a video on it. I think I might have a write-up on Sienna Chat, but that's about it. So I pulled the car out of the garage just to run it so we could run this thing. So once you plug it up and turn it on, you can see all the stuff that's on here. So you want to go diagnostics, but as you can see, it reads your voltage right here, 13.3 coming from the alternator. It has all these different things. It'll have an upgrade menu right here. And previously, when I first got this, it did a full update. And then I think I haven't used it for like 2 or 3 months, and I plugged it back up and it also did a recent update here. But every time you turn it on, it'll connect to Wi-Fi once you set that all up when it's new, and then it'll check for new updates and upgrades. So right now it's got all the latest updates, so we're good there, so we don't have to worry about it. So we'll go back to diagnostics, and then here we're Toyota, so we'll go ahead and select Toyota right there. And then you just go ahead and it'll explain to you what the diagnostics and all that does, but we are on version 51.1. Takes a little bit just to load everything, but you just gotta be kind of patient with all this. So what we have here, if it's not set up to North America already or wherever your region is, you go ahead and set your area, and then you can select North America, Europe, and other, and then Japan. So we're already in North America, so we got that set. And then this is gonna be the 16-pin DLC. So again, is this gonna keep on running all these? This thing is a serial communication, so it's pretty slow. And then we don't have radar cruise, so we'll go ahead and select other. And then we have the smart key on our version, so we'll go select that. And then the beauty of this thing is it pulls all the data about your vehicle, even the mileage on your cluster right there, and then what year your car is, what engine and everything. So you just hit okay. And it'll pull all the data on your vehicle as it scans it. So right now we're in the menu and you can see the various settings right there. You could go ahead and do the health report, and I'll run the whole thing and just scan all your codes and everything that's in here. So it'll go ECU by ECU, and all the current codes and the store codes, it will actually pull up. that this takes several minutes to do. And once it does it, it'll give you a whole list, and it'll also give you a summary of all the issues and what you, if you need to worry about it or not, or if you just want to go ahead and clear it all. So once you do that, you go ahead and hit report. And it'll pull up all the reports, and you actually email this to yourself so you can actually have it. But yeah, like for example, I've got this ECM, which is the engine control module code. You click on it, it'll be the just startability function. So it's so showing current and then history there. So that was, I think, when my battery ran out and it wouldn't start. So that's probably what it got that code early this couple weeks ago. Here, cruise control, startability malfunction. Again, just something that's stored here. Supple restraint, I'm saying it's passenger airbag mode indicator. Combination, so it lost communications with Navi and some other stuff. I think this was a while back when I swapped out the module on my, for CarPlay on my car. I've got a few more. Power seat malfunction. So none of these are current functions. So I could actually go all the way down or back and just go ahead and clear everything. I could clear all the codes and then it'll clear it all out from the system. And then we won't have to worry about it until it pops up again.
So next thing we'll do, we'll go ahead and go into the custom menus. This is probably what you guys all want to see. Even though there is a custom menu for this car, there's really not much you can do. A lot of it you can actually do on the screen already in the nav system or your infotainment system. Stuff like the lights, the seat belts, and the keyless entry stuff you can set on the actual car. But in here, they have those options too, like your wireless door lock here. So all the options here in the wireless door lock can be found on your menu on your car already. So you really don't need this tool for that one. So most of this is like the wireless control. You can control if you want to have that on or off. It's the hazard response, the door warnings, the lock and unlock and all that. So you could pretty much find that on the menu, but you could also see it here. Like the two lock operation if you want that. So as you click on each one of these, they'll actually explain to you right there what this function is and if it's on or off. Same with the door lock here. If you go there, it'll be the different options for your door lock. Here's the warning by horn if you do the double lock twice. And then the glass break sensor warning. So right now I have it on, but it's not functional because I don't have the optional glass break sensor on this vehicle. Go back. Security, so this is another thing worn by horn, so I actually have that on here. But so one of the options I saw in here that may or may not show up anywhere, but my vehicle did have when I set it in Techstream, was to actually turn the security system on. So right now I just have worn by horn. So this one is just for the glass break sensor and it's on. But on this vehicle, if you set the security system on, you actually have to have the hood pin, which this car didn't originally have as an SE. That only comes on the Limited, I believe, or the XLE. I actually had to get that replacement and add it on. So I have another video about that if you guys want to check that out. You got your power window options here. Again, the power window options kind of set all your different auto up and auto down settings. If you want to selectively turn those on and off, you can go ahead and do that in this menu. So you can see all the auto up, auto down. So you go to each window and disable or enable the buttons if you wanted to for any reason, especially if you have children in the back that you don't want to turn off all the windows, but you only want to selectively turn some on and off. You could do that here. Just remember you have to reset it or else somebody in the future is going to think that thing's broken. So wiper control, I don't think there's any options for wiper control here, but we'll click on that just to see. Some of these show up on here, but they might not be anything to set in them. So no custom data here. Illuminated entry, again, this is another one that I think you could set on the menu in the vehicle. Actually, no, just some of it you can. So in here are some of the settings. You got the reminder key. You got the low battery warning, you got the seatbelt buzzer, so you could turn those on and off right here. You have the passenger seatbelt buzzer, you could turn that on and off right here also. And then the lane change blinking, so that one you could change the number of time it blinks if you have the lane change monitor on your car. Illuminate entry, so again, that's another setting that you can set the different times that the lights are on and off as you walk by the car with your key and when you unlock your car. Air conditioner, that one just basically turns on and off the air conditioner. I think that was another setting that's on the menu on the infotainment system. But this one also gives you the ability to shift the temperature if you wanted to shift the temperature showing on there. If you wanted to change your compressor mode from automatic to manual or the evaporator mode. Same with the footwell defroster. You could turn those on and off. Those are the auto defrosters switching over. And then the outside air, if you want to have that as an auto or manual setting, you could set it here. Sensor, I don't think that has any options on this one. Nope. Display, that's for your cluster display. And really the only option is to show your odometer reading when the car is off. Unit conversion, I don't think that's anything that we can set here. Nope. We have the smart key access. Again, this is different ways to access or turn off all the sensors around the car. So you could do the wait time. You could do the door active or inactive, all your different sensors. Touch threshold, that's the, I think the touch over the door handle to lock the car. And then the door unlock mode, that's just all doors or one door. And then this is the power sliding door options right here. You could set those and you could change those settings right there. You could disable your power sliding doors on the either side through this function. And then in here, you also have the different buzzers that you can turn on and off the passenger or the driver sliding door. Different wireless operations, you could turn them on and off from your key. The seat, there's no seat and no other on here. So the next function we can look at is the service function or even the system selection, right? If you want to go system selection, you could go ahead and go powertrain, which has all the powertrain ECUs, or you could go all of them. Under all of them, you could go to things like the ABS system right here and go look at that system. And then you could read the fault codes. You could actually monitor the system as it's operating right now. You can monitor any of these solenoids right here and all this information and just like scroll through, because everything and anything that the system right here monitors, and you can see what the existing state of is. Parking brake is off right now. Now it's on. So those are the various things you could do there. You could go to special function, and this thing will actually let you do some of the diagnostics. So you could do the ABS reset. You could do an inspection mode. You could do air bleeding. So if you have a new ABS module or you need to air bleed that, you go in here and it'll go through the whole utility and show you how to air bleed, and it'll actually give you all the instructions to do that. So we'll go back here to the air conditioner. So you could again go in here, you can make adjustments, you can see what everything's doing, you could read the current, you could actuate and turn on different clutches, different defrost modes, the blower motor. You could do all that stuff there. If you go to the TPMS system, you can go in here, you could do the, you can read the current information from your sensors. So in here, as you can see, you could do, it has the oil reset light. I think that thing only tells you the instructions. It doesn't actually reset the light for you. Yep, the ABS bleeding, we kind of went over that earlier. You could do a throttle position reset. Tires, so your key immobilizer right here. You could actually go through and erase all your keys, which you probably don't want to do. You could register new IDs and new ECU. You could do the classic, and then you could go through and program a new key. So those functions are all in here. You could do the adaptive gearbox. So if your car has an adaptive gearbox where it kind of monitors how you drive and adjusts the gearbox, and you can reset all that information. Seat calibration, that one, I don't know what that means. Recalibrate your seat if you get a new ECU. And then air conditioning, again, that's just a server motor initialization. So that pretty much is a nice overview that I've gone over of most of the stuff that you can do with this thing. Alongside that, you could do your normal stuff of just reading codes and diagnostics and all that. And the beauty of this tool is that it kind of gives you that checklist, and it'll explain to you what each one of the errors mean. And then you can look up online, kind of give you an explanation of what is wrong with the car and how you go about fixing it or diagnosing it.
Hey guys, thanks for joining me all the way to the end of this video on showing you how to work this C-Reader launch tool for the Sienna. As you can see, it's a very useful tool doing all the different diagnostics and just doing different settings and everything. If you guys want your own, check out the links down in the description. I think these are on Amazon for about $120 with coupon. Most of the time, normal price I think is around $150, $160. Sometimes they'll have the promo for about $120. I think they're in stock right now, so just check out those links down in the description. Just for all of you guys that followed me all the way to the end of this video, I'm gonna go ahead and do a giveaway of this right now. All you have to do, leave a comment on this video, and then once you leave that comment, just screenshot it and hit me up on IG with your picture of your comment, and I'll put you in the drawing. If you guys found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to your channel, go ahead and subscribe to your channel, turn on bell notifications, get notified every time I upload a video. For all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.